Welcome to AXPONA 2014 here on our live stream at enjoymusic.tv. I'm your host, Stephen R. Rothen, and we are here with none other than Robert Harley, who is editor of The Absolute Sound. So, Robert, we've been talking about your book in some various YouTubes and even today earlier in our stream, and so we really appreciate you taking the time to come to the studio today.
My pleasure.
Now, you took, and I admire this, you know, you and other writers that write these incredible, you know, and produce these incredible books about audio equipment and whatnot. Why don't you tell everyone about the illustrated history of high-end audio, specifically loudspeakers?
Well, we set out to create the definitive history of the high-end audio industry, and we put together the table of contents and realized it wouldn't fit in one volume and really do the industry justice. So we divided it into three volumes, and the first volume, which has just been published, is on loudspeakers, the illustrated history of high-end audio. And we set out to document the inside stories behind the creation of today's iconic companies and their landmark products. So we conducted new interviews with the founders of these companies, like Richard Vandersteen and Arnie Newdell, Gail Sanders, and got new interviews with them. And we also asked for family photo albums, that photos have never been seen before, of their early prototypes, laboratories, and workshops. And the photos in the book are really amazing. The book's 320 pages and has 640 photos.
Now, this is top quality photography. I mean, we're not talking, I mean, it's beautifully bound, it's thick paper, it's really, really well done. I took a look at it earlier, and it really is impressive. Mm.
The book's the size of an LP cover, and we spared no expense in its production with four color printing throughout. Each page is varnished, it's a sewn binding, and we have full page 12-inch by 12-inch beauty shots of each company's most beautiful product.
Right here, if you hold that end, I'll hold this end. I mean, really, it's just, go ahead and, I mean, that is just so impressive. And look how big it is. I mean, now that you see Robert and I next to each other and now the book's open. Wow. Now, how long did it take you to do this?
Well, it took about a year to put together, and usually a book like this would take a lot longer, but we had 12 members of the Absolute Sound writing staff working on the book, and that's why we could do it in about a year.
Put it down, or if you want. Okay, so 70 pages, and let's see. They can buy it online at what would be the URL if they want to purchase it?
You can go to our website, taskbook.com, that's TASBOOK.com, and there you can find the complete table of contents, downloadable excerpts, and free PDFs that you can download.
Now, what was one of the most interesting things you discovered that you didn't know about when you were producing the book?
I'd say the most interesting thing was the stories behind the founders of these iconic companies. In many cases, they had no intention of starting a loudspeaker company. They were just enthusiasts who loved the music and couldn't buy the product that they wanted. So they built it in their garage, and other people heard and said, hey, this is fabulous, can you build me one? And that story was repeated time and time again. Like the story of Arnie Newdell, how he founded Infinity.
Yes.
He was a laser physicist, and he loved symphonic music, and he couldn't buy a speaker that reproduced the scale of a symphony orchestra. So he built, and he used servos in his job at Litton Industries. Hmm. So he applied servo technology to a woofer for the first time to make a loudspeaker that went really low in the bass. And he mated that to an electrostatic panel and came up with a thing called a servostatic. And so he took it to a local dealer who said, this is amazing sounding. I can sell these if you can build them. So Arnie said to him, well, if I did build them, it would cost as much as a Volkswagen, which was $2,000 in 1968. And the dealer said, well, that's not an issue. So Arnie built six pair, and the dealer sold them immediately. And based on that, Arnie quit his job and founded Infinity in his garage. And that story is repeated again and again. Richard Vandersteen was a truck driver who made the Model 2 in his garage. Jim Winey of Magnapan. So I think that's one of the things that makes this industry great. It was founded by people who didn't get into it from a business standpoint, but from a love of music.
And this is, as you said, repeated. It's the passion There's so many passionate people here at AXPONA. You know, these are the company owners. You actually can talk to the engineers. You know, they're tangible, and the products they build are built out of love.
That's right. They love music, and that's what drives the technical pursuit.
Anything else you'd like to tell us about the book, or any other items that you'd like to highlight?
It's filled with a lot of old photos that people have never seen before, like Richard Vandersteen loading the very first Model 2 into the back of his Pinto before even shipping cartons. And we have photos of Edgar Vilcher setting up the first live versus reproduced demonstration from the 1960s, those famous string quartet versus the AR-3 demonstrations. And the book covers the entire history of the loudspeaker, going back to its beginnings at Bell Labs and GE. We have full-page photo of the prototype loudspeaker from 1921, and it spans the entire spectrum up until today's modern companies like Magico and YG Acoustics. So it covers the entire spectrum over the book's 320 pages.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, we definitely thank you for taking the time to come join us on the live stream.
My pleasure.
Thanks, really. That's incredible.
Thanks. The reaction to it has been great.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. And as always, in the end, what really matters is that you enjoy the music.